This video is about crimes committed by public officers, and this is already our part 2. In this video, what we're going to discuss is Article 217. Article 217 is a bar exam area that is a bar exam favorite. So, malversation of public funds or property, and then there is this presumption of malversation. Article 218, that is the failure of accountable officer to render accounts. Article 219 is the failure also of a responsible public officer to render accounts before he leaves the country. Article 220 is another bar exam area, another bar exam favorite, that is the illegal use of public funds or property. This is known as technical malversation. Article 221 is the failure to make delivery of public funds or property. And last is Article 222, the officers included in the preceding provisions. Take note, Article 222 is also a bar exam topic, a bar exam favorite. So, in this video, what we are going to discuss is from Articles 217 to 222, we will be discussing their elements as well as the applicable bar questions para mas lalo ninyong maintindihan. I am so sorry if I was not able to upload videos last week. I was supposed to finish Rule 67 up to Rule 71 of the Rules of Court and upload also some criminal lectures for our criminology students. But I was exposed, me and my family was were exposed to a COVID-19 positive, so I have to take care first of our health. But tuloy ang buhay, but please stay safe, do our part in helping this government in fighting the virus. So let's go now to Article 217, that is malversation of public funds or property. So how do you commit malversation? First is by appropriating. By appropriating what? By appropriating public funds or property. Second, by taking or misappropriating public funds or property. Third is by consenting or by permitting another person to take such public funds or property. So how does he give his consent, or how does he give his permission? That is through abandonment or through negligence. And last is by being otherwise guilty of the misappropriation or malversation of such funds or property. Their common elements is, again, number one is offender is a public officer. Obvious naman to, because the crime is committed by a public officer. Second, that public officer had the custody or control of the funds or property because of his office or by reason of the duties of his office, and those funds or property were public funds or property for which he was accountable. Take note, ha? Those are considered public funds or property. Kasi pag private fund yan, then iba ang crime. Maaring estafa. Number four, so this is number four, is the ways of committing malversation. Again, he appropriated, took, misappropriated, or consented or permitted another person to take them through abandonment or negligence. So for application, let's go to this 1987 bar exam question. Pedro here is a municipal treasurer. So he received from the province 5 brand new typewriters. Each typewriter is valued at 10,000. Since Pedro needed money for the hospitalization of his sick son, he sold 4 out of 5, so 4 typewriters. He sold it to his friend Rodolfo, who is also a general merchant. Binenta niya ng 2,000 pesos, but the price really is 10,000. So, syempre si Rodolfo, because he is a businessman, he knew that the price is between 6,000 to 10,000. He agreed to buy the 4 typewriters. Kikita nga naman siya. So what did Rodolfo do? Rodolfo resold the typewriters at 6,000. So biro mo, binili niya ng 2,000, binenta niya ng 6,000. 2 months after the transaction, Pedro was audited, and the investigation as to his accountabilities led to the discovery that Rodolfo bought the 4 typewriters from Pedro. So question, what crime did Pedro commit? Answer is malversation. Bakit malversation? First, let's go to the elements. Who is our offender? Our offender is a municipal treasurer, therefore a public officer. And our offender or Pedro here had the custody or control of the brand new, five brand new typewriters. The reason why he has that custody or control is because of the duties of his office. And what is the nature of that five brand new typewriters? Was it a public property or a private property? Answer, it was a public property. Bakit? Kasi binigay yan ng province. He received it from the provincial treasurer of the province. And number four, what did Pedro do? What he did is he misappropriated the public property, or he misappropriated the five brand new typewriters. How did he misappropriate the five brand new typewriters? He sold the same to his friend. 4 out of 5. So this is also the answer of the UP Law Center. Pedro committed malversation. He received the typewriters from the provincial treasurer, and therefore they were under his custody, for which he is accountable as municipal treasurer. Selling four of the typewriters to Rodolfo because he needed the money for the hospitalization of his son constitutes misappropriation, as he applied the same for his personal benefit. Another bar exam question. Alan here is a municipal treasurer. He is a municipal treasurer of the municipality of Gerona. So he was in a hurry to return to his office after a day-long official conference. So he alighted from the government car, which was officially assigned to him, leaving the ignition key and the car unlocked, and rushed to his office. Pero mo, iniwan lang yung kotse. Jules here, a bystander, he drove off with the car and later on sold the same to his brother Danny for 10,000, although the car was worth 800,000. So what are the crimes, if any, committed by Alan, Danny, and Jules? So we will concentrate here kay Alan. Wag muna nating sagutin si Danny at si Jules. So what is the answer? The answer is malversation. Bakit malversation? Again, you go back to the elements. Who is our offender? The offender is Alan. Alan is a public officer because he is the municipal treasurer of the municipality of Gerona. And does he have the control or custody of a public property? Answer is yes. He was assigned a government car. The reason why he was assigned a government car is because of the duties of his office, or because of his office. And what is the nature of that government, of that car? That is a government car, so that is a public property. And what did he do? What did Alan do? He consented or permitted another person to take the government car. How did he do this? Through his negligence. Pinabayaan lang na bukas ang kotse at nagmadaling bumalik sa opisina. So this is the reason why the answer also of the UP Law Center is the same. Alan is liable for malversation committed through negligence or culpa. The government car, which was assigned to him, is a public property under his accountability by reason of his duties. And because of his act of negligence, he permitted the taking of the car by another person, resulting in malversation consistent with the language of Article 217 of the RPC. Another bar exam question. Here is a case between Andres and ABC Corporation. ABC Corporation is a government-owned or controlled corporation with an original charter. So natalo sa case si Andres, therefore, there is now an execution. So, in that execution, Eliseo here, the deputy sheriff, was the person responsible for the conducting of the execution sale at nagkaroon ng bidding during the execution sale and ang nanalo is si Gonzalo, the winning bidder. So Gonzalo purchased the property of Andres for 100,000 and then he paid the amount of 100,000 to Eliseo. Siyempre si Eliseo, he has that responsibility to remit the amount to the clerk of court. Dapat ibabalik niya yung pera. But what did he do? Eliseo lent the amount to Myrna, his office mate. Myrna promised to pay or to repay the amount within 2 months. Pero siyempre, anong nangyari? Hindi na ibalik ni Myrna ang pera. So despite demands of ABC Corporation, Eliseo failed to remit the said amount. State with reason the crime or crimes, if any, committed by Eliseo. Answer is, he committed the crime of malversation since he is a public officer who received the amount in his official capacity. Therefore, he is accountable for that 100,000 pesos. Another question, would your answer to the first question is still the same if ABC Corporation were a private corporation? Again, ano ba yung ABC Corporation? That is a GOCC with an original charter. So, paano kung magiging private corporation niya? Answer is the same. The crime is still malversation even if ABC Corporation were a private corporation. Bakit? This is because the 100,000, it came from the sale of property levied upon execution as ordered by the court. Therefore, that property was in custodia legis, meaning in the custody of the law. Although not strictly public property, it has become impressed with the new character of public property when Eliseo, the deputy sheriff, in his official capacity, he conducted the execution sale and received the proceeds or received the amount of 100,000 as a result of the bidding. So we'll go now to the presumption of malversation. Take note that if there is this demand from any duly authorized officer and there is a failure on the part of the public officer to have duly forthcoming any public funds or property with which he is in charge, then there is this prima facie evidence. Prima facie evidence of what? That he put the missing funds or property to personal use. So that is your presumption of malversation. Para lalong maintindihan, let's read this bar exam question. Randy is an NBI agent. So he was issued a rifle and a revolver. After a year, the NBI director made an inspection of all the firearms issued. Si Randy, he reported for work that morning, but nung nalaman niya na magkakaroon ng inspection, he did not show up during the inspection. Instead, he went on absence without leave, nag-awol. After 2 years, Randy surrendered to the NBI the two firearms that were issued to him. He was charged, of course, with malversation of government property. But Randy put up the defenses. What were his defenses? Number one is he did not appropriate the rifle and the revolver for his own use. Number two, that the delay in accounting does not constitute conversion. Number three, that it was actually his friend Chiting who the firearms were stolen by his friend Chiting. So decide the case. Answer of the UP Law Center is Randy is guilty of malversation or of Article 217. Bakit? Because first, Randy is an accountable public officer. He is accountable for the firearms that were issued to him by the NBI and they were issued to him in his official capacity. Second, the failure on the part of Randy to submit the firearms upon demand, what will happen? That will create a presumption. What is that presumption? The presumption that he converted the public property for his own personal use. So let's go to this 2001 bar exam question. Tingin tayo agad sa tanong. If you were the fiscal or prosecutor, what would be the nature of the information that you will be filing against the accused? Why? So this is a role-playing. So who is our accused here? Our accused is Juan Santos. He is a deputy sheriff in a regional trial court. So what did he do? He levied on the personal properties of a defendant in a civil case before said court. And among the properties levied and deposited were the among the properties levied upon and deposited inside the evidence room were refrigerator, cassette tapes, dining table, set of chairs, and several lampshades. So, si defendant here, he paid off the judgment creditor and then he tried to claim his properties. But he found out, the defendant found out that several items were missing at nagkaroon ng investigation. And what was the result of that investigation? The missing items were found in the house of the accused Juan Santos. But according to Santos, he only borrowed them temporarily. So, what is the crime or what information will you be filing against him? Answer is malversation. Bakit malversation? Because there was a misappropriation of public properties. Bakit naging public properties? Bakit naging public properties itong mga refrigerator, chairs, cassette tapes? These are owned by a defendant in a civil case. Because when that properties or when those properties were being under levied, they are now in custodia legis or they are now in the custody of the law. And if they are in custodia legis, then they are impressed with the character of public property. So in 1999, there was this question, how is malversation distinguished from estafa? So to answer that question, let's go first to Article 315. 315 is the applicable article if we are going to talk about estafa. Remember that estafa is a crime against property, while malversation is a crime committed by public officer. So there are three ways of committing estafa. First is with unfaithfulness or abuse of confidence. Second, by means of false pretense or fraudulent act. And last is through fraudulent means. So ito yung mga, yung under them are the ways of committing. And the common elements of estafa is number one, the accused defrauded another person. So how did he defraud another person? By means of deceit or by use of confidence. Number two element is there must be a damaged or prejudice. And that damaged or prejudice is capable of pecuniary estimation. Again, ha, there must be a damage or prejudice that is caused to the offended party or third persons. And last is the damage or prejudice may consist of number one, the offended party was deprived of his money or property as a result of the defraudation, or there is the disturbance in property rights or temporary prejudice. So to answer now this question, so in malversation, again, what is involved is a public fund or property. Take note, ha, what is involved in malversation is a public fund or property. How about in estafa? In estafa, what is involved is a private fund. And what did we say? One of the elements of estafa is there must be a damage or prejudice that is capable of pecuniary estimation. How about in malversation? There must be damage. Is there a damage also? Answer, no, because it does not require damage to the government. Bakit mo nasabi yan? Because if you go back to the elements of malversation, do you see that requirement of damage? Wala. So, it does not require damage to the government. So, these are the differences. Marami pa to actually between differences between malversation and estafa, but I'll give you only two for now. When we go to estafa, we will discuss this in detail. Let's go to Article 218, that is the failure of accountable officer to render accounts. Elements, number one is, again, the offender is a public officer. public officer, whether in the service or separated. Number two, he must be an accountable officer, accountable for the public funds or property, and there is this obligation to render accounts to the Commission on Audit or to a provincial auditor because he is required by law or by regulation, and he fails to do so for a period of 2 months after such accounts should be rendered. Article 219, the failure of a responsible officer to render accounts before leaving the country. Elements, number one, again, is offender is a public officer. He must be an accountable officer for the public funds or property, and he unlawfully left or be on the point of leaving the Philippines without first securing from the COA a certificate showing that his accounts have been finally settled. Si Article 218 and 219, hindi ko masyadong napapansin na tinanong sa bar exams. But of course, since you will be taking your bar exam or you will be taking your midterms or finals, just know that there are crimes such as Article 218 and Article 219. Article 220, that is the illegal use of public funds or property. Take note, ha? Article 220 is a bar exam area that is a bar exam favorite. Again, the offender here is a public officer, and there is a public fund or property that is under his administration, and that public fund or property has been appropriated. Appropriated by what? Appropriated by law or ordinance. And that public officer applied the same to a public use other than that for which such fund or property has been appropriated by law or ordinance. Your Article 220 is called also as technical malversation. Let's read this 2015 bar exam question para mas maintindihan. So there was this typhoon that destroyed the houses of many of the inhabitants of X municipality. So X municipality, what did it do? It operated a shelter assistance program. A shelter assistance program. Ano ang nangyayari sa program na to? Construction materials were provided to the calamity victims, but the beneficiaries provided the labor. The beneficiaries provided the labor. So the construction was partially done. When the beneficiaries, they stopped helping with the construction for the reason that they needed to earn income to provide food for their families. So when informed of the situation, Mayor Maawain, he approved the withdrawal of 10 boxes of food from the feeding program. There is a shelter assistance program and there is this feeding program. So when he approved the withdrawal of 10 boxes, they were given to the families of the beneficiaries of the shelter assistance program. The appropriations for the funds pertaining to the shelter assistance program and those for the feeding program were separate items on X municipality annual budget. So what crime did Mayor Maawain commit? Answer is, he committed the crime of technical malversation or Article 220. Bakit? Because the funds for the feeding program are not specifically appropriated for the beneficiaries of the shelter assistance program. Mayor Maawain has that duty to use only the boxes of food earmarked particularly for the feeding program, which would cater only to the malnourished among his constituents and not to the shelter assistance program beneficiaries. Another question, may Mayor Maawain invoke the defense of good faith and that he has no evil intention? Answer, no. Mayor Maawain cannot invoke good faith. Bakit? Because take note that your technical malversation, criminal intent is not an element. It is not an element. The law punishes, or technical malversation punishes, the act of diverting public property earmarked by law or ordinance for a particular purpose, and then you divert it to another public purpose, even if it is a public purpose. The offense is mala prohibita. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng mala prohibita? The act is not inherently immoral, but it becomes a criminal offense because there is a law that forbids its commission based on public policy, order, and convenience. Another bar exam. Here is Elizabeth. Elizabeth is the municipal treasurer of Masinloc, Zambales. So what happened to Elizabeth? Elizabeth here was charged with malversation of public funds. But was she acquitted? Yes, she was acquitted by the Sandigan Bayan for malversation. But what happened here is she was convicted for technical malversation. Convicted for technical malversation in the same criminal case. Of course, Elizabeth appealed and she argued that her conviction was erroneous. So is the contention of Elizabeth legally tenable? Answer is yes. The contention of Elizabeth is legally tenable. Bakit? Because when she was charged with malversation, that malversation does not include, or does it necessarily include, the crime of technical malversation. Magkaiba yan. Article 217, malversation, and Article 220, technical malversation, are two different animals. Maaring pareha sa pangalan, malversation, but they are different. In fact, if you go to the elements of technical malversation, ano ang importante dyan? Number 3, there must be a law or ordinance. And number 4, the officer or the public officer applied the public fund to another public use. And in that way, he violated the law because it was supposed to be used for this particular purpose. So that is the essence of technical malversation. So let's differentiate Article 220 from Article 217. Again, like what I said, these are two different animals. The technical malversation is not the same as malversation. But let's go first to their common denominator. What is their common denominator? The offender. Who is your offender? A public officer. But ito ay hindi basta-bastang public officer. He must be an accountable public officer. For their difference, first, in technical malversation, the offender or that accountable public officer does not derive any personal gain or profit. But in Article 217, in certain cases, the offender profits from the proceeds of the crime. Nakita naman ninyo dun sa mga bar exam questions na binasa natin. If the offender appropriates or misappropriates, then he profits from the proceeds of the crime, except dun sa negligence or abandonment. Second, the public fund or property is applied to another public use. It is another public use. Whereas in Article 217, the public fund or property is applied to the personal use, not public use, but personal use and benefit of the offender or of another person. Third, in technical malversation, kagaya ng sinabi natin, the act is mala prohibita. It is not illegal per se because it is used for another public use. But in malversation, the act is illegal per se because the public funds were diverted to personal use. Last is, in technical malversation, there must be an appropriation either by law or an ordinance. And there is no such requirement under Article 217. Let's go to Article 221, the failure to make delivery of public funds or property. So two ways of committing Article 221. First is there is this public officer. That public officer is under obligation to make such payment from government funds in his possession, but he fails to make payment, or the failing to make, by failing to make payment by a public officer. Another way of committing Article 221 is because there is this public officer who has been ordered by competent authority to deliver property in his custody or under his administration, but he refused to make such delivery. Therefore, they are responsible, or they can be charged with Article 221. So let's go to the elements of the first act. The public officer has government funds in his possession. He is under obligation to make payment from such funds, and he fails to make the payment maliciously. So take note, ha, that the failure to make the payment must be made malicious and must have resulted in damage to public interest. So let's go now to Article 222. Officers included in the preceding section, meaning to say from Articles 217 to 221. So, sino-sino ba ang mga ito? Private individuals are included, as well as administrator or depositary of funds or property. Ano ba itong funds or property? These are the funds or property that were attached, seized, or deposited by public authority, even if such property belongs to a private individual. Example ng administrator is your sheriff, the receivers. And for private individuals, they have in any capacity whatsoever, they are in charge of any national, provincial, or municipal funds, revenue, or property. To understand properly Article 222, let's read this 2017 bar exam question. Tingin tayo agad sa tanong. Discuss whether the crimes charged against Mr. Gulang are proper. So who is Mr. Gulang? Mr. Gulang is the president and CEO of Bawi. What is Bawi? That is Bangon Waray Incorporated. That is an NGO. It operates mainly as a social amelioration and charitable institution. Because of what happened to Tacloban City, that is strongest typhoon, Bawi received funds from all sources, local and foreign, including substantial amounts from legislators, local government officials, and the EU. But there were these complaints that there is a very slow distribution of relief goods and needed social services by Bawi. So, of course, if there were complaints, the COA will act on it. And according to the result of COA upon its audit, 10 million or at least 10 million worth of funds channeled to Bawi were not yet properly accounted for. Therefore, Mr. Gulang was criminally charged with Article 217 and Article 218, that is, malversation of public funds and failure of accountable officer to render accounts. But ano ang sinabi ni Mr. Gulang? Hey guys, I am not a public officer, therefore I could not be held liable with Article 217 and Article 218. So is the contention of Mr. Gulang correct? Answer, hindi. That is wrong, because ano ang sinasabi ni Article 222? 222 says that for Articles 217 to 221, that applies still to private individuals, as long as that private individual in any capacity is in charge of any national, provincial, or municipal funds, revenue, or property. This is also the answer of the UP Law Center. The charges against Mr. Gulang are proper, although he is a private individual. Another bar exam question which was asked in 2001, more or less the same lang ang facts dun sa nabanggit na natin kanina, yung previous slide. So, here are Reyes and Santos, Alex Reyes and Jose Santos. They were charged also with malversation of public property. But according to Reyes and Santos, they are not accountable officer. They are not accountable public officer. Therefore, malversation, they cannot commit the crime of malversation or they could not be charged with the crime of malversation. At most, ang pwedeng maikaso sa kanila is estafa, Article 315. But what is the proper offense really committed here? Answer is, the offense that was committed here is malversation and not estafa. Bakit? Reyes and Santos are depositary or administrator of properties, of public properties. Bakit naging public properties? Because these properties were sequestered. They were sequestered by the government. Therefore, they are in custodia legis. They are now in the custody of the law. And if they are in custodia legis, they are impressed now with the character of public property. And what did we say? Article 222, if you are an administrator or depositary of funds or property that were attached, seized, or deposited by public authority, even if such property belongs to a private individual, then you can be charged with malversation. From Articles 217 to 221, pwede kang kasuhan even if you are not a public officer. And what is again the presumption? There is that prima facie presumption that if you cannot explain why is the, in this case, the two delivery vans were missing kasi. If you cannot explain why they are missing, then there is that prima facie evidence that you have put the same to your own personal use. Another bar exam question, can a private person commit malversation? Answer, yes. If so, in what instances? There are two cases. Number one is if that private person is in conspiracy with an accountable public officer in the misappropriation of public funds or property in his custody. Or those in conspiracy with an accountable officer who is found guilty of malversation. Another answer is Article 222 of the Revised Penal Code. Article 222 applies to malversation or Article 217. Again, ano yung 222? Private individuals or administrator or depositary of funds or property. Just take note of the qualification. So down to our last slide, what crime is committed by a public officer who he has the control of public funds or property by reason of the duties of his office and he is accountable for that, but he permitted another person or he permits any other person through abandonment to take such funds or property, such public funds or property. Choices are letter A, the public officer commits malversation. The public officer commits technical malversation. The public officer commits the crime of failure of accountable or responsible officer to render accounts. And last is the public officer commits the crime of failure to make delivery of public funds or property. So the answer here is letter A, the public officer commits malversation. So this is the end of our video. Thank you very much for watching and have a good day.